founder of Dusenberry Entertainment. He's been involved in the games industry for over 30 years. Former CEO of Hasbro Interactive, of Games.com, Atari. Tom is closely associated with some of the great names in games: Monopoly, Trivial Pursuit, Frogger, Star Wars, NASCAR, Roller Coaster Tycoon, hundreds of other well-known games and brands. He is a creative, strategic thinker who can expand existing markets and develop new markets. His career focuses in digital entertainment and media content applications. He's currently active in the internet games market in mobile entertainment, social networking, and interactive applications in toy areas. He also is the owner, patented owner of in-theater interactive entertainment movie games, a breakthrough game platform that brings interaction to movie theater screen by utilizing smartphones and tablets as their controller devices. Tom also consults, is deeply involved in business development and product licensing. He's also a heck of a mentor to a lot of college students in the Commonwealth. He's also provides agent services to clients. He's truly a Renaissance man and as I said, a real legend in this industry. Welcome, Tom. Good morning, everyone. I hope I can live up to those words. I've been in the game industry my entire career, and it's been a great opportunity. During that period of time, I've actually created over $3 billion worth of games that have been delivered into the marketplace. And so when others talk about the creative economy, we're really making it happen. And I think it's important from that point of view to understand that it's all about creativity when it comes down to media and being able to deliver a fun experience. I find in my industry, or in my business specifically, that I have a truly global market. I because of LinkedIn, which has been one of the greatest revolutions in business in many years, I have contacts that and relationships with business people that come from Amman, Jordan, from Johannesburg, South Africa, from Moscow, Russia, from Hong Kong, from Tokyo, and many places in between. So in the game industry, you truly need to be global to be able to be successful. But I also find that the North Shore is ripe with creative resources that I utilize all the time. I find that there's great game design, there's great gamification design, game developers, copywriters, visualization people, everybody that I need to be able to make creativity happen within the media that I work in. So I think that the North Shore is a great place to, as a beachhead, to be able to do business because it's really a great portal to both the West and the East from a perspective of being able to get to your customers. If you go to the next slide, actually two slides more. I've been involved in the creative industry for 30 years. And you know, at Parker Brother Games, I had the opportunity to work with great brands like Monopoly and Nerf and Trivial Pursuit. And it was a blend of opportunity from a point of view that it was a very high caliber company and it had great brands to work with. In 1991, Hasbro purchased Parker Brothers, so it became part of the Hasbro family. And in 1995, I convinced the board of directors to create a new company within Hasbro called Hasbro Interactive and really pursue the PC business, the video game business, and the online business. After only two efforts with original content, we created the number one game, Roller Coaster Tycoon. So we hit, you know, on a very successful product. And we also had great products in the marketplace such as Frogger and NASCAR Heat, along with all the other Hasbro brands. In the last 11 years, I've been focused on my own business, Dusenberry Entertainment, where I've really been working on digital entertainment activities. I've built and sold four mobile game companies since I started Dusenberry Entertainment, and I've worked with all kinds of different activities as it relates to toys and physical or virtual products being brought together with toy apps. And today, I'm very focused on doing games within mobile, within online, and within the social arena, or specifically Facebook. So some of the mobile games that you might know about are games such as the Da Vinci Code, Slinky, Poker Superstars, and Slingo are all games that I've brought to the marketplace on the mobile platform. So we're quite excited about that. Today what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce to you three North Shore businesses that are active in the creative economy now. And interestingly enough, if you are interested in investment, all of these companies are at an angel investment level and might be something that you might be interested in because it's close to home for you and it looks like these companies could take off and deliver a nice return. So the first company I'm introducing to you is a company called Game Metrics. Game Metrics was located in Salem, Massachusetts. Interestingly enough, it actually won the Salem State University Business Planning Competition 3 years ago. And since that time, Bonnie Henry, if you know Bonnie, has come in and become the CEO, and I've actually taken on the title of Chief Game Officer. So I'm responsible for the games for this business. And basically what we're doing is we're pursuing the medical field. And specifically, we're going after health and wellness. And you find in the medical field that people have issues such as diabetes, and they try to take care of themselves, but they drift back to their old habits rather quickly. So one of the biggest issues within medical is engagement. How do you engage with these people and keep them on their medications and keep them healthy for a long period of time? Well, what Game Metrics does is we create engagement tools for health and wellness by way of using games and game mechanics to be able to make that happen. So if you go to diabetics.com, what you'll find is games such as Jeopardy, Solitaire, and Bejeweled, where you'll be able to play those games with a community of other people that have the same type of issues that you have, and then what you can do is create a friendship and a bond, and you come back over and over for that repeat play and that engagement. What we do from a gamification perspective is it's really an interesting company from a point of view that we do the traditional things such as leaderboards and incentive programs and recognition for the individual patient. But more importantly, what we do is we have a very sophisticated back-end technology that's able to take that data and give it back to the client. And the client is then able to read and interpret what kind of information that you're giving them, and then they can customize and personalize the program directly back to you to keep you engaged. So we're quite excited about what Game Metrics opportunity is in the future, and I'd like to show you a brief video right now on how games are played at Game Metrics. Okay, yeah.
Welcome to diabetesgame.com. In this short 1 minute video, I'm going to show you how simple it is to play our games. First, you're going to want to create an account so you can play the games and eventually review your scores. Once you have your account, you can select the game you want to play. Playing is easy because our games are the same popular games you already play on your computer. Your winning answers accumulate points, which you can exchange for great prizes. Visiting the Game Zone gives you access to all the games, leaderboards, and details of the rewards that you can win for playing. The My Page section gives your score updates and best games. Have fun and send us feedback on how we can improve your gaming experience.
What's interesting about Game Metrics is that we actually have a plug-and-play solution. So if you already have your website developed and you need that extra kick to get people to be engaged, we actually come in and we seamlessly integrate into your website. And so that increases that engagement and then all those tools that you're able to utilize. The next company we're going to speak about is a company that's based in Lawrence. It's called Wonder World Entertainment. Wonder World Entertainment has been around for about 8 years, and it does 3D animation for TV programs. So its star product on the next slide is a TV show called Ribbit and Robert. It's on public broadcast stations. And Ribbit and Robert is a show that is focused on education. And what happened with the creative people at Wonderworld Entertainment is we went to the educational departments of the different states and learned what the curriculums were to be able to be a student prepared to go into kindergarten. And what we did is we built 78 TV episodes for that 3 to 6 year old to prepare them for kindergarten. And that's what Ribbit and Robert is all about. I'm going to show you a video in a minute, but what's really happened with this business is it's kind of gone through its normal product cycle, and the TV show has kind of gotten to the point that it's been around for a while. Interestingly enough, we found a brand new distribution channel that could actually dwarf the TV opportunity from a revenue point of view, and that's the kid tablet. If you think about today, you've got the iPod, you've got the Galaxy tablets. Those are great, but if you want to give a $400 or $800 tablet to a 3 or 4 year old, that's kind of a challenge for some of the parents. So what has emerged is a brand new business called the kid tablet business. And you'll hear names such as LeapPad and Meep and Tabio. And those are the new kid tablets that are in the marketplace. 2 years ago, they didn't exist, and at the end of this year, what's going to happen is that there'll be over 20 million kid tablets in the marketplace. So we're able to deliver Ribbit and Robert directly into that marketplace. And what's unique about it, because it's interactive, we can also add games, activities, and actually a diploma so the child can see that they've successfully done what the program is for each of the individual shows. So with that, I'd like to show you a brief video of Ribbit and Robert.
Ribbit and Robert's Learning Link apps feature 78 half-hour episodes of Ribbit and Robert's Wonderworld, a multi-award-winning public television series that prepares children for early school success in preschool, kindergarten, and first grade.
Built around the best early school curriculums available, Ribbit and Robert covers a wide range of academic and social topics, from colors, numbers, and weather, to having fun on a rainy day and being a good sport. Ribbit and Robert's Wonderworld is one of the most awarded children's shows, winning four of the industry's most prestigious awards: the iParenting Media Award, the Kids First Best Award, an all-star rating from the Coalition for Quality Children's Media, and the National Parenting Center Seal of Approval. The Ribbit and Robert Learning League Promise. The goal of the Ribbit and Robert Learning League is to help children excel in preschool, kindergarten, and first grade, while teaching them to love to learn and learn to love in everything they do.
Please contact Wonderworld Entertainment for more information about Ribbit and Robert's Learning League apps. Thank you.